This patient has severe to profound hearing loss and has been a cochlear implant candidate for many years. But given her lifestyle, she really didn't feel that she needed to pursue it because she could use visual cues and some lip reading in combination with powerful hearing aids to get her daily activities completed. And then once the pandemic began, she really just had more trouble because she lost that visual input and now is considering getting a cochlear implant to help her communicate.
It's been difficult at times, yes, but it's more difficult now because of the masks.
I find it easier to understand when they're talking directly to me, okay? Or when I'm seeing them, yeah.
I feel the masks are really very hard for people with hearing. I think you have to be honest and upfront in your activities. In anything I was doing, I always told people that I was speaking to or have business to do with, I always told them I have a hearing problem. I think that helps.
If you're looking for options for different types of masks that make communication easier during the pandemic, you can find that on Dr. Mills' video on the YouTube channel for the House Clinic. So the pandemic doesn't change whether or not people who have hearing loss are cochlear implant candidates. It really just is part of the decision-making process for them. So if someone is a cochlear implant candidate, they may choose to have an implant or choose not to have an implant based on their lifestyle and if they can function well with the level of hearing that they have. The pandemic basically changes a little bit of that decision-making process.
Say I have that and you're talking to me. Does your voice come in like your voice?
No, it's more mechanical, like a robot. But the word clarity is better.
Okay, if the doorbell rings,
you would hear it.
Can I know that it's you know that, or is it just a noise, or do you know it's a doorbell?
It depends. Sometimes you have to retrain the brain to understand signals.
Yeah, that's what I read.
And so it does improve over time.
Is there an age cutoff on this surgery?
So if you're healthy and you need a cochlear implant and you can get clearance for cochlear implant, you can have a cochlear implant. The oldest person I've implanted is 93, and she did great. It really improved her quality.
I have to hurry up then, don't I?
No, you can be the new record holder.
Hi, I'm Erin, Associate Director of Education and Global Hearing Health here at the House Institute Foundation. Thank you for watching our video. If you would like to support research, education, or global humanitarian efforts, please consider donating by clicking the link in the description box below. Be sure to check out our other videos, like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you can get notified anytime we post. Thanks.